What's up, guys? My name's Brandon, and a little bit earlier than expected, Apple has officially released the first public beta of iOS 15. And in this video, I'm going to be showing you how to get that beta on your device for free. And this is going to work with any iPhone, iPad, or iPod Touch that was able to run iOS 14. Now, if you installed the iOS 15 developer profile on your main device, I would recommend switching over to the public beta as soon as possible, and I'll talk more about why and how to do that later on in this video. But this is just going to be a very straightforward tutorial on how to get iOS 15 public beta on your device for free. So let's not waste any time. Let's go ahead and get straight into it. So the first thing you guys want to do is go ahead into Safari, and from here, you want to go to beta.apple.com. beta.apple.com and click on go. And when you get there, you will see this page right here where it says Apple Beta Software Program. And down below, you will see iOS 15, iPadOS 15, macOS Monterey, tvOS 15, and watchOS 8. So you will be able to get all of those from those select devices. But for this video, we're talking all about iOS and iPadOS. So from here, you just simply want to tap on sign up. And after you enter your Apple ID, it's going to take you to this page right here where it says guide for public betas. So it's gonna tell you a little bit about iOS 15. It's going to tell you about providing feedback, the diagnostics, things like that. But the main thing you guys want to do on this page is right underneath of get started, it says enroll your iOS device. You want to tap on that. And then after you tap on that, it's going to take you to this page right here where it tells you exactly what to do before installing iOS 15 public beta on your device. So these are basically things that I would normally tell you in a video, but Apple does a good job of laying it out here and telling you what to do. But the first thing you guys want to do is make sure you back up your device. So before you install iOS 15, you want to make sure you have an iCloud backup. It says an iTunes backup, but I think that an iCloud is good enough. So if you want to go and make a backup right now, just go into your settings, go to your iCloud, go to iCloud right here, and then go down to the bottom to iCloud backup, and just make sure you do a backup now. That way you have a very up-to-date backup. And of course, you want to make sure that everything is selected right here so you get all of your stuff over on iOS 15. You probably will not lose any data, but just in case something goes wrong, you want to make sure that you have that backup set. So after that, it tells you to install profile. So right here, you will see this blue button that says download profile. Go ahead and tap on that. It's going to bring up this page right here where it says this website is trying to download a configuration profile. You want to tap on allow, and it's going to say profile downloaded. Now we want to go back into our settings. Let's go all the way back. And then up top, you should see where it says profile downloaded right there. Just tap on that. And it says iOS 15 and iPadOS 15 beta software. Let's go ahead and tap on install. Enter our passcode, and then it's going to take you to this consent page right here where you see some terms. Let's tap on install, install once again, and then it says a restart is required. However, it's not required. You could just tap on not now if you do not want to restart. Tap on done. Now, if you go into your settings and go to software updates, you should see iOS 15 populate right there. So you can see mine says iOS 15 public beta 2, even though this is public beta 1, so I'm not sure why it says that. But that is how you get iOS 15 public beta on your device. And of course, if you want to download and install this, just simply tap on download and install, and it will begin installing on your device. Now, one thing you guys want to keep in mind when installing iOS 15 public beta on your device is that not all applications will work right away. So you might have some applications, especially banking applications, that do not work right away on iOS and iPadOS 15. So just keep that in mind. Applications do still need to be updated, and this still is a beta. We are not getting the final version of iOS 15 until the fall. So just keep that in mind when installing this. And another thing you guys want to do is make sure you use the feedback application. So this application right here will show up on your device after installing the public beta. You want to make sure that you report any of your issues that you have with iOS 15 in terms of bugs or just connectivity issues, anything at all. You want to make sure that you sign into the feedback assistant and report the bugs so that Apple can fix them. Just sharing your issues on social media is going to do no good. You want to make sure you use the feedback application to report any and all bugs that you encounter. And of course, if you guys want to see all of the new features included in iOS 15, I did make a big video showing over 100 new features in the software, and same with iPadOS 15 as well. So those videos will be linked down in the description below. Now, for those of you who are on the developer profile right now, should you switch over to the public beta profile? And I say yes, 100%, if it is on your main device, the device you use every day. And the reason I say that is because you're going to avoid the major bugs that could literally brick your device, just like we recently saw on a 14.7 developer beta. So I would definitely recommend deleting the profile for the developer beta and going ahead and signing up for the public beta. So you will get your beta releases a little bit after the developers get theirs, but you will avoid any of the major issues that you could have been, you know, having on your device if you had that developer profile installed and you were running those developer profiles. So I would definitely go ahead and do that. And if you guys don't know how, just go into your settings, go to general, then go down to profile, and then tap on the profile you want to remove, and then just simply remove the profile just like so. And actually on iOS 15, it's a little bit different. So if you go into your settings and then to general and then down to VPN and device management, and then tap on that, that is where you see the configuration profile in iOS 15. So it's slightly different in iOS 15, but if you had an iOS 14 profile installed, that is where you go to delete the iOS 14 profile. You may have had the public or the developer beta. That's where you go on iOS 14. So anyways, guys, there you have it. That is a quick tutorial on how to get iOS 15 public beta on your iPhone or iPad. And of course, you can download these public betas for all the other operating systems as well. So like macOS Monterey, watchOS 8, things like that. You can also install from the same website. That's just beta.apple.com. But if you guys enjoyed this video, and if you're looking forward to trying out iOS 15 on your device, I would appreciate if you gave this video a thumbs up. And of course, make sure you subscribe for a lot more iOS 15 content coming to the channel very, very soon. But anyways, guys, thanks again for watching, and I'll see you soon.